Welcome friends to OneStop Java Solutions. I am Sneha Sis and today I am going to solve TCS Proctored assessment of 28th December 2019. Okay. So in the previous video, I already implemented the first two part and now I am going to implement the third part. Okay. So here you can see create a static method get movie by January. Okay. So that part I am implementing. So for that, write a static method. Okay. So here you can write a method that's static. Class name is, the method name is get movie by genre. Okay, so get movie by genre, and it will take two argument, which will take the object of array and search string as parameter. So it will take two argument. One is the movie array. Okay, so and another is the string genre. So string genre is the one parameter and another is movie array. Movie and give the name as error. Okay, so it will take argument and the return type. Okay, so return type, what would be the return type? It will return a movie object. So here you can see parameter has returned a movie which are matching with the genre search. So it will return a movie object. So it will return a movie object. Okay. Okay. Now, so it will take, it will, this movie array will take the four object, movie object. Okay. So four movie object it will take. So inside this method, I am creating one movie array. Another movie array that will also with the size of 4. Okay, because you are sending the 4 movie object, 4 movie object. Okay, so movie, I am giving the name as array. Okay, movie arr1, movie arr1 equal to new movie 4. New movie inside write the 4. So this is the another array of type movie, means that can hold the 4 movie object also. Okay, so in this array I will store the matching movie object. Okay, so this one and I am declaring one variable j equal to 0. Okay, and what I will do, I will write here a for loop that will iterate 4 times. Okay, so for int I equal to 0, I less than 10, sorry not 10, I less than 4 and I plus plus. So for every iterate it will check if arr I, if arr I, okay, dot get genre. Okay, so you have to filter the object with genre type. Okay, get genre dot equals whatever genre you are sending to this method. Okay, so if this is equal with this genre, then what I will do, I will store that movie object to the arr1. Okay, so arr1 j plus plus equal to arr i. Okay, so this part, see this part very carefully. So what I am doing, so this is my get movie generic class, movie generic class method. Okay, so this method takes two parameter, one is the generic string and another is the array movie. So this array movie get four movie object. Okay, so that four movie object, you have to check which movie object the generic type is this generic, means whatever you are sending here. Okay, so if any of this movie object inside this array is matched with this generic type, then I am storing those object, movie object, inside the new array that I have created here, array one. Okay, and then finally outside of this loop I will check if j equal to 0, that means there is no matching criteria. Okay, so means nothing matched, so then I will give some message and stop the program. Okay, so here I am giving a message, if j equal to 0, then I will give the message no such criteria matched. Okay, no such criteria, no such criteria matched. Okay, and then I will means terminate my program. Okay, system dot system dot exit, system dot exit passing the zero, that means normal termination. Okay, so I am terminate this code. Okay, and if j not equal to zero, okay, if j equal to 0, then it, if j not equal to 0, then I will return error. Okay, so here I will return error 1. Okay, so I am returning error 1. So this error 1, this method is called inside the main method. So here you can see, okay, I not yet call that method. Okay, so I have to call that method inside the main method. Here enter the generic and store the generic here. Okay, inside the generic string. So after that I will call that method. Okay, so after that I will call that method and I will store in a movie array. So movie error one, okay, equal to, so I am creating a movie array and then I am calling this method get generic. Okay, with these two parameter, one is the generic, so here I am sending two parameters, one is the generic and another one is the error. Okay, this array, because this array containing the four movie object, so using these two I am calling this method and the return type I am storing in the error one. Okay, and now so I will get the all the filtered value of the movie object. Okay, inside this error one. So now the fourth part that I have to do, I have to give the input and I have to print. Okay, so if this is the fourth part, if budget less than 8000, okay, of those movie where I have passed the generic type. So if whatever generic type I will pass, so if it is matched with that generic type, then I have to check if the budget is less than, by budget is greater than 8 crore. Okay, then it will only print the low budget movie. So that part I will explain in the next video. Thanks for watching this video.